Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. Aladdin was the son of a poor tailor. He was a lazy boy and played all day long. After his father died, his mother earned money by spinning cotton. One day, a man came to their house and claimed that he was the brother of Aladdin's father. Aladdin's mother was surprised when she heard this, as she knew Aladdin had no uncle. The man talked about how much he loved his brother and how sad he was to hear about his death. He gave Aladdin some new clothes and gifts. Aladdin's mother began to believe that this man was actually Aladdin's uncle. Then he said,
"Sister, why don't you let Aladdin come and work for me?"
Aladdin's mother agreed instantly. He then took Aladdin to a far-off place outside the city. They soon reached a place that had a cave and was surrounded by trees. There the man said,
"I will show you something wonderful."
He lighted fire and threw some magic powder in it. A big square stone with a round brass ring on it appeared. Aladdin was astonished to see this. The man said,
"Pull up the brass ring, nephew, and go into the cave below. There you will see a lot of priceless shimmering jewels, diamonds, gemstones, gold and silver. You will also find an old lamp there. Bring that lamp to me and then take what you want from the cave."
Aladdin was frightened. Still, he gathered courage and lifted the stone and saw some steps leading down into the cave. He went down and found everything as he had been told. He found the old lamp lying in a corner.
"That's strange,"
thought Aladdin.
"Why should he want only an old lamp?"
Picking it up, he turned back towards the opening of the cave. He called out,
"Uncle, give me your hand to pull me up."
"Give me the lamp first, and then I will pull you up,"
the man replied. Aladdin was afraid now that the man would leave him there if he gave the lamp first. He replied,
"I will give it to you, but first let me come out into the open air."
The man got angry. He said,
"Then stay in the cave."
He threw some magic powder on the square stone and shouted a spell. The stone moved and the cave's entrance was closed. The man left the country forever, which clearly showed that he wasn't Aladdin's uncle. He was actually a wicked wizard who wanted to use the boy's services for his own benefits. After Aladdin would bring him the lamp, the wicked wizard's plan was to shut Aladdin in the cave and leave him there to die. For 2 days, Aladdin was trapped inside the cave. He shouted there several times, hoping that someone would come and help. But there no one came. He became weak with hunger and thirst. As Aladdin was sitting alone, he accidentally rubbed the lamp with his hand. Suddenly, the cave was filled with a very bright flash and a genie appeared. Aladdin couldn't believe his eyes. The genie bowed to him and said,
"I am the servant of the lamp. My home is in the lamp. And the man who owns the lamp owns me. I will do anything you command. What I can do for you, master?"
It was a huge man who looked strange, and Aladdin was afraid of him. But he gathered courage and said to Genie in a shaky voice,
"Take me home."
In a flash, he was back in his own home. Aladdin thanked the Genie. He hugged his mother and told his mother about the meal, the cave, and the Genie. His mother did not believe him, so he rubbed the lamp again. But now, when the genie appeared, they were not afraid of him. Aladdin asked the genie for a palace, And soon they were living inside a beautiful palace instead of the old hut where Aladdin had lived all his life. Within a short span of time, Aladdin became the richest man of the town with the help of Genie. He and his mother lived happily ever after.